Om Gyanatimaranda Sya Gyananjana Shalakaya Chakshurmilitanyena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Vanchakalpatarubhyascha Kripa Sindubhayevacha Patitanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavibhyo Namo Namaha Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Srivasadi Gaur Bhaktavinda Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama 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 Hare Hare. So we're going through the 11th canto of the Srimad Bhagavatam, and we're in chapter number 2, where Maharaj Nimi is meeting with the nine Yogendras.
我们继续来讲《圣典不教要谈》第11篇第二章，马哈拉什尼米和九位有根智的会面。
So now Maharaj Nimi is hearing from Javier, who is one of the nine Yogendras. And Javier, Maharaj Nimi wanted to know about different levels of devotees. He wanted to understand the different levels of devotees. So Javier is explaining to him about the three different levels of devotees.
马哈拉什尼米想要了解，奉献者都分为哪些层面，所以哈维尔就向马哈拉什尼米讲述了有几个层面的奉献者。
So tonight we're beginning to hear about the devotee on the lowest stage, the Prakrita Bhakta, or a materialistic devotee.
今天晚上我们将听到最低层面的奉献者叫 Prakriti Bhakta，就物质的奉献、物质主义的奉献者。
So this devotee, he faithfully worships a deity in the temple, but he doesn't behave properly towards the devotee or to people in general.
这位奉献者忠心耿耿的在庙宇里崇拜神像。但是他并不尊重别的奉献者，也不会尊重普通大众。
So, although he worships a deity nicely, he's not aware that the Supreme Personality of Godhead is all-pervading.
虽然他能够很好的去崇拜神像，但是他不明白。至尊性格神手是遍存万有的。
So, we see this mentality, especially in common people today, that they commit all kinds of sinful activities in their home, but then they go to the church and pray to God for mercy.
我们看到，当今年代。这种现象在普通人中大有人在，他们在家中做各种各样的罪恶活动，然后他们会去教堂向神祈祷。
So actually, God is in our home. God is not only in our home, he's in the street, he's in our office, he's in the forest, he's everywhere.
实际上，神就在他自己的家里。神也在大街上，也在办公室里，在森林里，无处不在。
And God's meant to be worshipped everywhere by devotional service.
人应该透过奉献服务，在每一个地方都去崇拜神。
We heard earlier in this chapter that a devotee shouldn't see anything separate from the Supreme Lord, Krishna.
我们在这一章的前面的部分听到，人不应该把别的事物看成是跟主分离的和 Krishna 分离的存在着。
He should consider that earth, water, fire, air, ether, the sun and stars and all people, all living beings, that they're all expansions of Krishna.
他应该看到，土、水、火、空气、大地、以太、太阳，其他的发光体，所有的生物，它们都是神的扩展。
And if we see everything that exists in the creation as the body of the Lord, the devotee should offer his respects to these expansions of the Lord's body.
如果我们把存在的一切都看成是神的身体的扩展，那我们都应该把现有的存在的一切向他们致敬。
So this is the kind of vision which a Mahabhagavat devotee, the greatest devotee of the Lord, will have.
这就是一位 Mahabhagavata，一位最伟大的奉献者的誓语。
And a Madhyama Adhikari, the devotee on the middle stage, he will see the Supreme Lord as the cause of all causes, and he will offer his love to the Lord.
一位玛迪亚玛的终极奉献者，会这样看待主，这样看待主，他，
Aribo,
Hare Krishna。
you finished? Yeah.
No, no, no，一位终极的奉献者会把至尊跟神手看成是万缘之源，所以他献把爱献给主。
Yeah. So that devotee, he also is a friend of other devotees.
这样一位奉献者是其他别的奉献者的朋友，
And he is merciful to the ignorant, and he will avoid the atheists.
他对那些愚昧无知的人非常仁慈，他也会去远避那些无神论者。
But his realization of the all-pervading feature of the Lord is not perfect.
但是他，对至尊主的遍存万有的特征的觉悟是不完美的。
He has his mood is that everyone is ultimately meant to be a devotee of the Lord, and he tries to use everything in the service of the Lord.
虽然他意识到每一个生物终极来说都是至尊主的奉献者，而且万事万物都应该用来服务主。
And he is aware that everything is meant. It belongs to the Lord, but he's worried that he may be bewildered by the association of atheistic people.
他也能意识到万事万物都属于主，但是他很担心他会因为和那些无神论者的联谊而感到困惑。
Now, the devotee who is on the lowest level, on the very lower stage, the materialistic devotee, he cannot understand that the Lord has the power to exist outside of the temple or outside of the church.
一个最低层面的奉献者，一个物质主义的奉献者，他不明白主，至尊主，他有能力存在于教堂或者是寺庙外面。
He's proud of his own worship in the temple, and he cannot imagine anybody is more pious or religious than he is.
他对自己在庙宇当中的崇拜感到非常的自负，他无法想象还有谁比他更虔诚，或者是更有宗教心。
He doesn't even think any other devotees could be more advanced than him.
他甚至不能意识到还有哪些奉献者甚至比他更为进步。
So he cannot understand the intermediate and the topmost level of devotional service.
所以他不能去理解，终极的或者是高流的对主的奉献服务。
So sometimes he will criticize the more advanced devotees and he will neglect them.
有时候他会批评主的那些进步的奉献者，或者是对他们熟视无睹。
He cannot understand that they're more advanced, they're preaching, and they can often be also self-realized souls.
他不能理解这些更高级的人物，他们是更伟大的传教士，也是已经觉悟了，自我觉悟了的灵魂们。
And this Kanishta, this materialistic devotee, he's often fascinated by the material qualification of some bit of great materialistic people.
这些物质的奉献者。低流的奉献者，他们会被那些了不起的物质主义者的物质的资格，因为他们的资格而感到被迷惑了。
So he has a bodily because he's in the bodily conception of life, so he's attracted by material opulence.
因为他自己是处在躯体化的生命概念中，所以他就会被物质的富裕深深的吸引。
So this minimizes the position of the Lord.
而这恰恰是，贬低了至尊主的地位。
And this materialistic devotee, he gets disturbed if the intermediate devotee will criticize the non-devotees.
倘若终极的奉献者批评那些非奉献者的话，那么这些初级的奉献者会感到内心十分不安。
This materialistic devotee thinks he's being compassionate by approving the non-devotional activities of materialistic men.
这些物质的奉献者认为他们允许那些物质主义者从事非奉爱的活动，是对他们展示的怜悯。
So this materialistic devotee, he doesn't have any knowledge about the higher level of devotional service.
这些物质主义的奉献者对于奉爱服务的更高层面一无所知。
He thinks devotional service is just some religious aspect of life. But he thinks there's many enjoyable and other non-devotional things which are there.
他们会认为奉爱服务只是生活的一些宗教活动或者虔诚活动，他们以为生命当中还有许多可供享乐的事物，还有很多非奉爱服务的方面还可以享受。
So sometimes he will become angry with the intermediate devotees.
所以，他们有的时候会对那些终极的奉献者生气。
Especially when the intermediate devotees criticize non-devotees.
尤其是当他们听到终极奉献者批评非奉献者的时候。
So this person, although because he has faith in Krishna, he's a devotee, but he's on the lowest standard.
这样的人，因为他们对 Krishna 有信心，所以确实是奉献者，但是处于最低的层面。
So if this materialistic devotee follows all the rules and regulations of deity worship, then they'll gradually be elevated to a higher standard. And they'll go on and become pure devotees.
倘若这样的物质的奉献者追随神像崇拜的所有规范原则，他们将逐渐的被提升到奉爱服务的更高标准， 逐渐的成为，最终成为主的纯粹奉献者。
But if they commit offenses against other devotees, then that will stop their advancement.
但是，倘若他们对其他的奉献者做出了冒犯的话，那么这将会阻碍他们的灵性进步。
And if they neglect or don't show proper respect to the devotees, then that's considered an offense at the lotus feet of the Lord.
倘若他们忽视了主的奉献者，或者是对其他的主的奉献者漠不关心的话，那么他们就成为了主的莲花族的冒犯者。
And also, if somebody disrespects the demigods, then they will also lose devotional service and they will remain in the material world, taking birth again.
除此之外，如果他们不尊重对半神人，不尊重失敬于半神的话，他们也会失去奉献服务的机会，并且被迫在生死当中再度的轮回。
Demigods should always be offered respect because they are devotees of the Supreme Lord.
半神人们总是应当受到尊敬，因为他们是主的奉献者。
And if someone's envious of the demigods, then he is considered envious of the Supreme Lord.
谁要是嫉妒了半神人，那么他就是嫉妒至尊主。
And the same way, if somebody offers genuine respect to the demigods, then he's respecting the will of the Supreme Lord.
谁要是对半神人们致以真诚的敬意的话，那么他们就是在尊重至尊主的意志。
At the same time, a Vaishnava does not think that there are many gods. He knows there's only one Supreme God.
因为 Vaishnava 并不认为有许多的神，他知道只有一位至尊主。
They know that the Lord has a mission in the material world to reform the conditioned souls.
他们知道主在物质世界有着自己的使命，就是为了改造那些体困的灵魂。
And in the Lord's mission, the demigods, they're considered to be limbs of the Lord's body.
在主的使命当中，半神人们被认视为是主的躯体的四肢。
Now, at the same time, in the Bhagavad Gita, chapter 7 says that if those whose minds are distorted by material desire surrender unto the demigods and follow rules and regulations according to their own nature.
与此同时，在国家梵歌的第七章世界20是这样说的：那些心意被物质欲望扭曲的人们，臣服半神人们，按照他们各自的本性，用特定的规范原则来崇拜半神人。
But at the same time, we should understand there's many examples of devotees who worship the demigods to get benedictions to serve Krishna.
我们也要明白，有许多这样的先例，有奉献者们，他们去崇拜半神人，是为了得到祝福，好服务 Krishna。
For example, the gopis worship demigods to get Krishna.
例如，Gopi 牧牛姑娘们崇拜半神人们，是为了得到 Krishna。
They worship, at the end of Chaturmasya, there's a time called the Katyayana Vrat, and that's the time all the young girls of Vrindavan. They will all take bath early in the morning in the Yamuna and pray to get Krishna as their husband.
在查图马夏末尾的时候，四月苦行末尾的时候，有一个卡提亚亚娜，Brat，也就是那些牧牛姑娘们会在冰冷的亚穆纳河水当中清晨去那里沐浴，以期得到 Krishna 作为他们的丈夫。
Another example is Rukmini Devi, that on the day of her marriage, she went to the temple of Ambika and worshipped the goddess Ambika, but her only goal was to get Krishna, to have Krishna as her husband.
另外一个例子是 Rukmini Devi，在她大喜的日子的当天，她去了 Ambika 女神的庙宇来崇拜女神，但她内心唯一的想法是要和 Krishna 在一起。
And sometimes also the preachers of the Krishna consciousness movement will cultivate very rich, important people by showing them a lot of kindness and diplomacy, so that they will use their wealth and their influence in the service of Krishna.
当今呢，Krishna 之间运动的一些传教士们，他们会去培养，刻意的培养那些重要的富裕的人士，对他们毕恭毕敬，非常有礼，而且擅长的对待他们，好让这些有钱有势的人们。将他们的物质资源从事于服务 Krishna。
So we can offer our respects to the demigods so that they will give facility for devotional service of Krishna.
我们是可以向半神们致以全部的敬意，让他们给予我们便利条件来为 Krishna 做服务。
And that is not against bhakti, it's not against the path of devotion.
而这点并不违背奉爱的道路。
Of course, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he recommended the Sankirtan, chanting of the holy names of Krishna. So this is the only realistic process for this age.
Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 推荐了 Harinam Sankirtan。唱诵主的圣名作为这个年代的唯一的切实可行的方法。
But a devotee should be careful not to go against, not to offend the demigods and based on the wrong understanding of the instructions in the Bhagavad Gita.
然而，主的奉一位奉献者，不应该就是得罪半神人，而假借薄伽梵歌中主的训示，误会了薄伽梵歌当中主的训示，去得罪半神人。
We should remember that the demigods, they are bona fide Vaishnavas.
我们要明白，半神人们是正宗的外师那吧。
But we have some material desires, they're mixed devotees, they're not pure devotees.
半神人们，他们有一些物质欲望，他们是混杂的奉献者，他们不是纯粹的奉献者。
So if someone does not respect Lord Vishnu, then that's very bad, and all the demigods will they will feel very they'll feel hatred or anger towards that person who doesn't respect Lord Vishnu.
是哪个人？倘若是不尊重主为什么的话，半神人就会 憎恨，就会对这样一个人生气、动怒。
This person who's not respecting Lord Vishnu, he can be pushed into the darkest regions.
这样一位不尊重主的人，会被推到最黑暗的地狱。
And the Lord himself may push the person, or the demigods may push him.
或者是主本人，或者是半神人，会将这样的人推向最黑暗的地带。
And it's also said that the topmost devotee, the Uttama devotee, that when he gets liberated, he will enjoy the company of the Supreme Lord and the demigods.
也有这样的说法，当奉献者们得到，最高的解脱之后，他会获得主以及半神的直接的陪伴。
So the demigods are there in the association of the Supreme Lord.
所以，半神人们，他们是处在和至尊主的联谊当中。
Now, Jiva Goswami, one of our acharyas, he says that the materialistic devotee, because he cannot respect other devotees, he will also not respect ordinary living entities who are not even devotees.
Jiva Goswami 是我们的先辈 Acharya，他说，一个物质的奉献者，不可能，他们连其他的奉献者都不尊重，更何况去尊重那些普通人呢？而普通人甚至都谈不上是奉献者。
So this kind of materialistic devotee, he's useless for preaching work unless he comes to a higher platform of understanding.
这样一位物质化的奉献者，实际上在实际的传道工作当中是没有用的，除非这样的物质化的奉献者将自己晋升到更高的理解层面。
The materialistic devotee, his faith is not based on any Vedic scripture.
物质化的奉献者的信心，并不是建立在经典的基础之上。
And he cannot understand the exalted position of the Supreme Lord in everyone's heart.
他无法理解至尊主处在众生心中这一崇高的地位。
So he cannot actually have love of God, nor can he understand the position of the devotees of the Lord.
既不能去爱神手，也不能理解主的奉献者的崇高地位。
Just as Krishna is glorious, Krishna's intimate associates are also glorious.
正像 Krishna 是光荣的，Krishna 的同友也是光荣的。
But the materialistic devotee, he doesn't know this.
而一个物质化的奉献者对此是一无所知。
So the most important qualification of a Vaishnava, of a devotee, is that they will offer all respects to others.
一位 Vaishnava，一位奉献者的至关重要的 资格品质是他会向其他人致以全部的敬意。
But the materialistic devotee, he doesn't do this.
但一位物质化的奉献者不会做到这一点。
But if he has faith in the Vedic scripture and tries to understand the scriptures like Bhagavad Gita and Bhagavatam, then he can gradually come to the second and even first class level of devotional service.
如果这样一个人对伟大经典有信心，努力的去理解博伽梵歌、博伽瓦昙的话语，他将逐渐的被晋升到二流甚至一流风爱服的层面。
And Prabhupada's spiritual master, Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasvati Thakur, he says that a materialistic devotee should seriously worship the deity.
赫普帕德的灵性导师圣巴提斯丹塔萨尔萨迪塔库说：“一个物质化的奉献者应该非常认真的去崇拜神像。
The deity is an incarnation of Krishna.
”神像是 Krishna 的化身。
So Lord Krishna can come before the person worshipping him in five different forms.
Krishna 可以以五种不同的展示来到一位崇拜者面前。
First of all, there's Krishna's original form.
首先有 Krishna 最原初的形体，
Then his quadruple expansions.
还有他的四重扩展。
And then his pastime incarnations.
其次是他的消时光的化身。
And then there's a super soul.
还有超灵，
And the fifth one is the deity.
而第五个形体是神像的形体。
So within the deity form is the super soul.
在神像的这一形体之内呢，就有超
And
灵。
the super soul is also within the Lord's pastime forms.
超灵也在主的逍遥时光形体中。
And the Supreme Lord's pastime form is coming from the Chaturvyuha, which is the quadruple form.
主的逍遥时光形体是来源于 Chaturvyuha，是它的四重扩展的形体。
And so this quadruple form is within the supreme truth,
而
Vasudeva.
四重扩展又包含在至尊真理 Vasudeva 之内。
And that is within the another form called the Swayam Prakash Tattva, which is an expansion of the ultimate original form of Krishna within Goloka.
而这 Vasudeva 形体呢，又包含在 Svayam Prakasha Atva 之内，而 Svayam Prakasha 是由最原初的灵性天空 Goloka Vrindavan 最原初的 Krishna 形体，是由这个原初的形体而来。
So you can see there's a hierarchy of the expansions of the forms of the Lord.
从此，我们可以看到，至尊主的扩展，它是有一个阶梯的。
And this will depend on how eager we are to render service to Krishna.
而这是取决于我们为 Krishna 做服务的渴望程度。
So the beginner in the lowest stage of devotion, they should try to dedicate all their activities for the satisfaction of Krishna.
一位初习者，一个初级层面的 应当把所有的活动用于取悦主。
And they should cultivate the worship of Krishna in the temple.
他们应该培养去崇拜庙宇当中的 Krishna。
And it said all the different expansions of the Lord, they all come into this world and they enter within the deity.
据说主的所有的扩展，他们都降临到这个世上，进入到神像当中。
The deity shows the function of the super soul.
神像它就展示了超灵的功能。
And they accompany, they take part in the daily life of the Vaishnava.
他们参与了 Vaishnava 的日常活动。
And the pastime expansions of the Lord, they incarnate at special times.
而主的消时光的扩展，他们在世代特定的时期才降临的化身。
And the super soul and the deity forms, they're always available for the advancement of the devotee.
超灵和神像的形体总是在那里。可以帮助奉献者取得灵性的进步。
And when we come to the intermediate platform, then we're able to understand the expansions of Krishna.
当我们来到终极的层面，我们就可以有能力去理解世尊主的扩展。
But the materialistic devotee, the Kanista devotee, he only knows about the deity.
而物质化的奉献者，Anishta 奉献者，只知道，神像。
But Krishna is so kind, he encourages even that lowest, the lowest level of devotee. He encourages him.
而 Krishna 是如此的仁慈，他鼓励了这样的奉献者。
Lord Krishna puts all of his different forms into the deity. And so by worshipping the deity, the materialistic devotee is worshipping all the forms of the Lord.
主呢，就把自己放在神像的形体当中，这样通过崇拜神像，一个 Kanishta 奉献者就在崇拜了主的所有的形体。
So, as the devotee advances, he can understand these different forms of the Lord, both in this world and in the spiritual world.
随着奉献者取得进步，他能够明白，在这个世上以及在灵性世界，就主的所有这些形体。
But if one remains on that, on the materialistic platform of a devotee, if he remains on that Kanista platform, then he won't appreciate the blissful nature of the blissful nature of Krishna's paraphernalia and all of his entourage.
倘若一个人还是处在这个三流的层面上，他就不能够去欣赏到至尊主的随身用品和他的随行人员的极乐的本质。
So there's an example that Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu didn't want to meet with the king. So instead of meeting with the king, what he did was he sent one of his cloths, one of his outer piece of cloth, he sent it to the king. And when the king got it, the king began to worship the cloth and he made it like a deity.
在这方面有个例子，这个国王Prataparudra，主柴丹尼亚并不喜欢去见这位国王， 主呢就将自己的此一块布，一个他的外面的衣服的一块布给了这个国王，而这个国王就立刻开始崇拜这块布，就像崇拜主一样，而且把这块布呢就当做一个神像来崇拜。
He understood that that cloth was not different. It was as good as Lord Chaitanya himself.
国王明白这块布就像主本人一样好。
Actually, the worship of the paraphernalia or the devotees of Krishna is even better than the worship of Krishna, and that Krishna is more pleased by this worship.
实际上，从对主的随身用具和奉献者的崇拜，甚至比崇拜主本人更好。而主就对这样的崇拜更为满意。
So the materialistic devotees, they're not able to appreciate Krishna's devotees and their paraphernalia.
物质主义的奉献者无法欣赏主的同奉献者。主的随身用具。
So that shows us that the materialistic devotee is still affected by the speculation and by the Mayavadi and Karmavadi philosophy.
这表明，物质主义的奉献者仍然受到心智推敲，Karmavadi、Mayavadi。假象宗哲学，还有果报，功利性，哲学的影响。
Means they're still interested in sense gratification and they still speculate about the nature of the absolute.
意味着他们仍然对感官享乐津津有味儿，他们也对于绝对者的，也对绝对者有着非人格的推敲。
Srila Prabhupada would sometimes say that the impersonalists, they like to see Krishna alone, but a devotee, they like to see Krishna with his cows and with his or with his friends, or with the gopis, or with his parents, or so on, but not alone.
圣帕帕德时常说，非人格主义者渴望见到 Krishna 独自一个人，而奉献者渴望见到 Krishna 和他的母牛、朋友、父母、母牛姑娘和他的随身用具在一起。
Devotee enjoys the beauty of Krishna in Vrindavan,
奉
surrounded
献。
by all his beautiful associates.
奉献者们，喜欢看到在 Krishna 在 Vrindavan 四周环绕着他那些美丽的童友们。
And we see the mercy of Krishna's devotees, how they travel around the universe distributing Krishna's mercy.
我们看到 Krishna 的奉献者的仁慈。他们在整个宇宙，去旅行，来派发 Krishna 的仁慈。
They bring the dust particles from Krishna's lotus feet and they place it on the heads of the conditioned souls.
他们把 Krishna 莲花足上的尘埃放在受条件限制的灵魂的头上。
And somebody's not interested in Krishna's paraphernalia and his entourage and devotees, then they have the wrong understanding of Krishna. They must be contaminated due to some impersonal philosophy.
谁要是对主的随身用具，同游奉献者不感兴趣，他一定对至尊主有个错误的理解， 还受到非人格主义哲学的污染。
Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasvati Thakur says that after hundreds of lifetimes of worshipping the deity of Lord Vasudev with paraphernalia, then we can realize the true nature of the holy name.
Shem Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasvati 说，Thakur 说，经过几百世的忠诚的崇拜主 Vasudeva 的神像，随身用具去崇拜主 Vasudeva 的神像之后，几百生世之后，一个人才能觉悟到主的超然的名字的真正本质。
So, a materialistic devotee, the Kanishka, he gradually comes to understand the mental activities of a devotee and he tries to advance to a higher stage.
一位物质化的奉献者，Kanishta 奉献者，会逐步的理解一位奉献者的心理活动，并且努力的将自己晋升到更高的层面。
So gradually, he will lose his material conceptions and he will develop a loving mood towards Krishna and make friendship with the devotees who are the dear servants of Krishna.
逐渐的，他会失去，丧失他的物质化概念，他会向至尊主展示爱意，并且和主的奉献者交友，而主的奉献者是主最亲密的仆人。
And he will become eager to engage innocent people in the service of Krishna.
他们会渴望让那些天真无邪的，人们去从事为主做服务。
And as he begins to make more advancement, then he will oppose anyone who tries to stop devotional life.
随着他取得深入的进步，他便会反对任何人，去反对任何阻碍奉献服务的人。
And they will avoid the atheistic people who cannot benefit by, even if we give them good instruction, they cannot be benefited.
他也会尽量避免那些无神论者，这些无神论者，即便给了他们很好的教导，他们也从中没有什么收益。
So anyone who helps for with the Krishna consciousness movement, then they're engaging in preaching work for the pleasure of Krishna.
任何人帮助Krishna 这些运动，他就是在协助主的传教工作。
So you can see the devotees in our Krishna conscious society, they can quickly come to the second class state, to the intermediate level of devotional service.
所以，我们从中可以看到，这 Krishna 这些运动的成员可以迅速的上升到奉献服务的中级层面。
At the same time, we have to be careful not to just become interested in collecting money for maintenance.
与此同时，我们要小心，不要仅仅对于收敛钱财来维系 自己的生活感兴趣。
But if we give up, if somebody gives up preaching and just becomes interested in collecting money, then this is a type of envy of other living entities.
你
This
是
is
要
materialistic.
倘若谁要是放弃了传教，而仅仅只对收敛钱财感兴趣，那么这种就是一种嫉妒的心理，这个就是对其他生物体的嫉妒。
So, Maharaj Nimi's two questions have been answered.
Maharaj Nimi 的两个问题就得到了回答。
He wanted to know about what is the nature of devotional service to the Lord.
他的第一个问题是，对主的奉献服务的本性是什么？
And he wanted to know what are the specific duties of the Vaishnavas.
第二问题是，一位 Vaishnava 的特定职责是什么？
So, Javi is going to go on and describe about the topmost devotee.
Abby 将进一步来描述一流的奉献者。
So he said, even though he may engage his senses in contact with their objects, but if he sees the whole world as the energy of Lord Vishnu, then he is the greatest among devotees.
尽管他的感官和感官对象产生了接触，但是他将整个世界都看成了主的能量，这样一个人是最高流的奉献者。
So we should understand that the position of the first class devotee, the topmost devotee, it's so worshipable that now different symptoms are given. In the next 8 verses, they're going to describe the different symptoms of the first class devotee.
一个高流的奉献者，他是如此的值得崇拜，以至于在接下来的8个世节都描述了这样一个高流奉献者的特征。
So it says, unless we come in contact with the lotus feet of a pure devotee, the path of freedom from illusion is difficult to understand.
据说。除非一个人接触到了主的纯粹奉献者的莲花足，否则的话，要想摆脱物质幻象之途，是这条道路是很难以理解的。
Right. Now, in the Upadeshamrita, the Nectar of Instruction, Rupa Goswami had described how to associate with different devotees.
在圣 Rupa Goswami 的教诲的甘露的诗节当中，描述了该如何跟各类奉献者交往。
Right. Sushrushaya. Sushrushaya bhajana vijnana ananyan anyanandati sunyam ridam ipsita sangalabhya. So Rupa Goswami had described we should honor a devotee who chants the holy name. Mentally honor. In our mind, we should honor a devotee who's chanting the holy name.
Saint Rupa Goswami 说：“我们应该在我们的心意里去尊重那个唱诵了圣名的奉献者。
And we should honor a devotee who's engaged in worshipping the deity and has been initiated. We should offer obeisances to that person who has taken second initiation and who's engaged in worshipping the deity.
而对一位已经得到了二次启迪，并且已经在从事着，崇拜神像的这样的奉献者，我们应该顶拜他。
And on the topmost level, we should associate with and faithfully serve that pure devotee who is advanced in undeviating devotional service and whose heart is devoid of the tendency to criticize others.
而对于一个，内心已经处在通爱佛的最高层面上，他的内心丝毫没有批评他人的倾向，他完全从事于百折不挠的、专心一致的对主的奉献服务的这样一个高流的奉献者，我们应该去跟他联谊，忠心耿耿的服侍他。
So Rupa Goswami says a devotee must be intelligent enough to distinguish between the materialistic devotee, the intermediate devotee, and the topmost devotee.
圣如果勾萨米也说，我们应该有足够的智慧去区分哪些是物质化的奉献者，哪些是终极奉献者，哪些是高流奉献者。
A neophyte devotee. Or a devotee situated on the intermediate platform, it can also accept disciples. But such disciples will be on the same platform.
一位初级奉献者和中级奉献者也可以接受门徒，但是他们所接受的门徒，只能处在和他们同样的层面上。
They cannot advance very well. Under because his guidance will not be so good.
这样的门徒无法得到很好的进步，因为他们所得到的指导并不是很充分。
So a disciple should try to accept the topmost devotee, the Uttama devotee, as his guru.
一位门徒应该接受一位 Uttama Adhikara，一个信高流的奉献者作为 guru。
So we're going to hear different symptoms so that we can recognize who is actually the bona fide spiritual master.
我们将要聆听他们的特征，这样我们好来辨认出谁是一位真正的灵性导师。
All right, we're going to stop here tonight.
那我们今天晚上就讲到这里。
Are there any questions?
yes。那第一个问题是来自于，这个一二三，他说顶拜 Guru 圣典波迦坛10.8.50描述。雅收的是永恒解脱的灵魂，Devaki 是靠灵修解脱的灵魂。雅收的和 Devaki 都是 Krishna 喜乐能量的扩展，都是 Krishna 的永恒同融。为什么说 Devaki 是靠灵修解脱的灵魂，不是永恒解脱的灵魂呢？Devaki 做了12,000天堂年的苦行僧。还做了 Krishna 的母亲。So in Srimad Bhagavatam, Canto 10, Chapter 8, Verse 50, described Yashoda is eternally liberated souls, yet Devaki is liberated by spiritual practice. So my question is that since both Yashoda and Devaki are expansion from Krishna's Ladini Shakti, they are both eternal liberated, both Krishna's eternal associates. Why Debaki is why it is said Debaki is liberated by spiritual practice, not eternal liberated souls. And Debaki has become Krishna's mother by tapasya for 10,000, 12,000 heavenly years and become Krishna's mother.
Yes, you have to read the books more to understand this. You have to understand that Devaki and Vasudev, they did tapasya to get the Lord as their child for three births, right? Previously, they were Prishni and Sutapa, and they did great tapasya for a long time to get the blessing of having the Lord as their child for three births.
你应该更多的读书去理解。Devaki 和 Vasudeva 他们从事了苦行，以期得到主作为他们的孩子，然后他们得到了主作为他们三世的孩子。有一世，第一世是 Krishna 和 Sutapa，然后他们苦行，然后他们得到了祝福，主成为他们的孩子。有三世可以做他们的孩子。
So you can see also Lord Krishna appeared as their child in Mathura. So Vasudeva and Devaki, they offered prayers to Lord Krishna.
当 Krishna 在马图拉以他们的孩子的身份显现的时候，他们就向主献上祈祷。
But Mother Yashoda never offers any prayers to Krishna.
而亚修的母亲是从来没有向 Krishna 献上祈祷。
Mother Yashoda, she only sees Krishna as her child. She doesn't think of Krishna as God. She can only think of him as her child. And she's always praying to the Lord to protect him. And she would chant prayers for Krishna's protection.
亚修的母亲只是把 Krishna 看作自己的孩子，她从来不想 Krishna 是神，她向主祈祷，主能够保护她自己的孩子，她甚至念祷文来保护 Krishna。
So Mother Yashoda and Nanda Maharaj, they're the ones who enjoy Krishna's childhood pastimes. They're always Krishna's mother and father. Vasudeva and Devaki, they got the boon to give birth to Krishna as their child, but they could not enjoy the childhood pastimes.
亚修达和 Nanda 能够享受到 Krishna 的孩提的小时光。他们总是 Krishna 的父母，而 Devaki 和 Vasudeva 是得到祝福才生下了 Krishna 作为他们的孩子，他们没能享受 Krishna 的白提的逍遥。
You can see Mother Yashoda, Nanda Maharaj, they're very, very exalted souls. They're always the parents of Krishna. They're the only ones to enjoy Krishna's childhood pastimes. Krishna gave birth to, appeared as a child to Vasudeva and Devaki. He was with them for a few moments, and then immediately they brought Krishna to the home of Nanda Maharaj. And then after Krishna killed Kamsa, Krishna's already grown up, he's already older, and then they brought Vasudeva and Devaki out of the prison house, and Krishna's with Vasudeva and Devaki, and they went to Dwarka. Mother Yashoda and Nanda Maharaj, they never go to Dwarka, they stay in Vrindavan. But Vasudeva and Devaki, Krishna went with them to Dwarka.
Nanda 和 Yashoda 他们的地位特别的崇高，他们总是 Krishna 的父母，能够享受到 Krishna 的孩提的笑容。而Krishna 做 Vasudeva 和 Devaki 的孩子呢，只是片刻的时间，然后就立刻被带到 Nanda 的家中。在 Kansa 被杀死，然后 Krishna 已经长大之后呢，他才释放了他的Vasudeva 和 Devaki 去 Dwarka， 又继续做了他们的孩子。而 Nanda Yashoda 从来没有去 Dwarka， 他们一直在Vrindavan。
Okay.
Her question is that whether or not Devaki is eternal liberated souls or only liberated by practice.
Well, that's what it says, right? You want me to contradict what it says in the book? Well, we have to accept what it says in the book. But the book, it says Devaki became liberated by practice.
那这书里是这么说的，是 Devaki 是靠灵修解脱的灵魂。那你是不是想让 Guru 的话是跟经典作对呢？经典说的就是说经典说的就是对的。那下一个问题是 Guru Pala Gopi Vidasi， 那 Guru 只要还有物质欲望，就还是物质化的奉献者吗？如果奉献者不能对所有层面的奉献者产生敬意，不还是物质化的奉献者是吗？ If devotee still have material desire, then he is materialistic devotee, profiter devotee.
Yes.
是的。The next part is that if devotee cannot respect all level of devotee, then this devotee is on the anishta level.
Yes.
是的，就是答案都是肯定的。下一个问题 ，Ananta Lila， 你麦古尔的零二九，其他信仰的代表，例如基督徒，即使不是素食主义者，也可以被视为忠于上帝吗？古鲁 ，if 其他信仰的 ，if devotee of other cult。For example, Christian, even if they are not vegetarian, when we regard them as faithful to God.
Well, they believe in God. They may not know very well who is God. They don't know very much about God.You know, generally they often think Jesus is God. They don't know much more. But they have faith in God. But their faith is very it's like blind faith. They don't know much about God. They don't really know who he is. But they might say he's Jesus.Then you have a difficult time with them. Generally, Prabhupada told us that We don't preach to Christians unless they agree that you shouldn't eat meat. Unless a Christian is willing to admit that meat eating is wrong, then don't waste your time in preaching to them, because you won't get nowhere.
他们也不知道神是谁，帕帕德说呢，我们一般不向基督徒传教，除非他们承认吃肉是错误的，否则的话，会很浪费时间向他们传道，而且这种传道工作也取得不了多大的进展。 The next one, Vrindavan Prema is asking. 有时候Kumara似乎很累，他如果用对皮马。 This devotee asked that sometimes Kumara seems very tired, so she's asking how to deal with the fatigue.
How do we deal with fatigue? Well, we deal with it by taking some rest, usually.
一般我们一般就通过休息来对付疲劳。
But sometimes we just get tired because we don't have any service. And once we get some service, when we're active in service, then we're not tired. But we get tired when we don't have enough service.
有的时候，是原因是因为没有得到足够的充分的服务，一旦得到服务呢，就会再度的活跃起来。正因为没有得到充分的服务，所以才感到疲劳。下一个问题是 Ananta Lila， 当我们崇拜神灵时。 是否应该在这些神灵中冥想阿拉玛特吗？神像是神像吗？ When we worship the deities, do we meditate on Paramatma?
When we worship who?
神灵，您那个神灵是神像吧？ Maybe she's saying when we are worshiping deities, whether or not should we meditate on the Paramatma?
No, you can meditate on the deity.
崇拜神像，你就冥想神像。The
deity is manifest before us. It's much easier to meditate on the deity, which is manifest directly in front of you. Why should you meditate on something which is not manifest?
就是神像已经直接的展示在我们面前了，去冥想，直接展示的那么容易，为什么还要去冥想没有展示给我们的超灵呢？
Mm-hmm. No more questions, huh?
no more questions, no more questions.
Okay. So thank you
Thank
very
you.
much, Maman Ganshia Gurumani Mataji, ke Maman Fani. Ganshia sorry to function, sir.
Oh, there's one more question.
Okay.
张雪说，估计每位众生都是同一个超灵 Krishna 吗？可理解像太阳的源头，照在每人身上的光，对吗？这个问题不太清楚，每位众生。She's asking whether every living entity is the same super soul Krishna. Can we understand it is like the source of the sun? Mm-hmm. 你这个问题看不懂。Panamuki 吗？你能理解这个问题吗？或者您直接开麦吗？举手。So she is asking whether each living entity is. Cannot understand the question。下一个问题，Sumitra 说，Sumitra 对 Dasi，因为生物体总有缺陷，是否终极奉献者的做法或对初级奉献者的批评，初级奉献者都要接受吗？So Guru。Because living entities they are always defect in living entity. So for the behavior of Madhyamana Adhikara devotee and the criticism for the neophyte devotees, should all the neophyte Kanishtha devotee accept the behavior of Madhyama devotee and accept the criticism, all the criticism for
Yes, they should.
And
They should think the Madhyama devotee is being merciful to them by pointing out their fault.
是的，这个答案是肯定的。是的，他们都应该接受，他们应该想，就是终极奉献者是对他们仁慈，所以来指出他们的错误，这就是对，本身是对他们的仁慈的体现。
Yes.
She says thank you. She says thank you, Gurudev.
Okay. So no more questions?
No more questions.
Okay.
Ananta Lila said, 我们怎么才能为马尔服务，让他不感到疲倦？How can we serve Maharaj so that he will not feel tired?
By asking nice questions.
那你就提出非常精彩的问题，提出很好的问题，优质问题。
Okay, so thank you very much, Guru Mani, for
Thank
translation.
you.
I thank all the devotees, Vamagansha, so the functions, Vamajufuniman, Tamadaryo Kwaila, One An, Hare Krishna,
Hare Krishna, thank you, Mara, for your mercy.
Srila
Shantaja.
Prabhupada Ki Jai.
Jai. Srila Bhaktivedanta Narasimha Mara Ki Jai. 好，感谢所有奉献者的聆听。Hare Krishna。